Thank you very much, and interesting with this growing studies you do here in Qatar, where you have a very good control over patients, and that's very interesting to follow. The next presentation is from Dr. Olivier Martin, also here from Qatar. And you are a senior sport PT at the Aspire Academy, if I correct. So, and your presentation is Prevalence of Groin Injuries and Association with Growth Spurt in Pubertal Elite Qatari Soccer Players. So this is a prospective epidemiological study over two consecutive seasons. Please.
Good morning. Following this previous interesting talk about adult athletes growing epidemiology, I'm quite delighted to present some characteristics from the youth soccer development. Youth soccer development, it's an important focus here in Qatar, and the World Cup in 2022 as well highlight this this focus. And sorry. I was saying that youth soccer is an important focus here in Qatar for the country. When, as a clinician, when you are working with a young soccer player, you should realize that you are as well dealing with a spectrum of different skeletal maturation. Also, during the adolescence, the growth spurt is a characteristic of this period of the life. And with an immature skeleton, the physis has been shown to be the weakest part of the muscle tendon bone complex. Therefore, apophyseal and physial stress injuries can occur, and they have been recognized recently as overuse injuries and as well underreported in the literature. If we look at the literature, there is still not any comprehensive growing epidemiology in youth soccer. And overall, we know that we have a prevalence of 7.5%. And the main figures, interesting, as a clinician, that there is a higher rate of growing injuries in early and normal maturers. And osteochondral injuries related to growing were accounting for 41.5% of the total lower limb growth-related injuries. So the purpose of our study was to examine the magnitude of the growing injuries here in our academy, explore the growth-related apophyseal injuries, and investigate the relationship with the somatic maturation to finish this presentation. Our cohort includes 349 youth soccer players from 10 different age groups. The data collection was done over two seasons by experienced sport physicians and sport physiotherapists in youth soccer. We include all football-related injuries, considering as well the medical attention, the no-time loss injuries. How do we define our apophyseal injuries? Based on the anamnesis, the clinical examination with the symptomatology, the pain at the insertional points with the palpation, passive, active, and resistive positive finding, of course, in association with the corresponding muscles. Differential testing outcome as well has been considered, neural testing negative. Imaging has been involved also in our study, done by X-ray, MRI, and ultrasound, on bilateral comparison and expert reports. Regarding the somatic maturation, for the people who are not familiar with such information, here we have the typical growth curve during the adolescence. And today, we can estimate the age at peak high velocity as indicator of somatic maturation. The age at peak high velocity is the period of maximum growth in stature in the growth spurt, let's say, in the adolescence. And by the predictive equation, we can then define the age. And based on the standard deviation, in between minus and plus 1 year, the players is during in the period of his peak high velocity. When the player is more than 1 year before his peak high velocity, is before pre-PHV, and when the player is more than 1 year after his peak high velocity, is post-PHV, after the peak high velocity, then the growth spurt. So, as an overall prevalence, we found 12.3% of growing injuries in our core. 23.4% were no time loss, a mean layoff per injury of 12 days. Regarding the growth-related injuries of the growing area, they were accounting for 47.5%, including 5.6% of avulsion fracture. If we look at the different apophyseal injury in accordance of the location, from the less prevalent to the most prevalent physis, the ischium got a prevalence of 1.7%, the iliac crest 3.4%, the lesser trochanter 11.9%, the pubis 16.9%, the anterosuperior iliac spine with a prevalence of 18.6%, and the most prevalent area was anterior inferior iliac spine with a prevalence of 47.5%. If we look at the incidence by the different age groups, we found that we have a very low incidence of the overall growing injuries in the age group from under 9 up to under 12, then a first significant increase up under 13, and then a substantial important increase in under 14, with a peak incidence in under 16. Now, if we consider only the apophyseal injury type, we didn't find any apophyseal injury related injury in under 9, under 10, and then a very low rate under 11, 12, and 13, and then a substantial increase in under 14, 15, and 16. And as well, one more characteristic that I would like to highlight is that this type of injury still remains in under 17 and in under 18. Our survival analysis, in comparison with the youngest team below under 14, found that players from age group of under 14 and 15 and 16 have an hazard ratio of 5.87. And the oldest one, under 17 and 18, have an hazard ratio of 3.81. Only for the growing apophyseal injuries, the hazard ratio of the players from under 14, 15, and 16 is 14.37, and as well, the hazard ratio of under 17, 18 players is 6.24. The last part of our result is the association with the somatic maturity and the PHV, and we found that before peak high velocity, the growth spurt, the rate, the incidence of injuries of the total growing and the apophyseal injuries is quite low. But during the circum, during the growth spurt, the overall incidence is substantially much higher, and as well, the pelvic growing apophyseal injuries is the most higher incidence. After the peak velocity, the growth spurt, we remain 0.45 incidence of the overall growing injuries, and we still have 0.17 as apophyseal injuries after peak velocity. Our survival analysis found that the player during growth spurt have 13.51 more chance to sustain an apophyseal injury of the pelvis in comparison with a player before growth spurt. And the player after growth spurt still have a risk of 5.51 compared with the youngest player. So, to conclude, the prevalence of the growing injuries is similar to a professional football player's. We have a very low incidence in the age group below under 14. The growth spurt period is associated to a greater chance of growing and pelvic injuries. And regarding the apophyseal injuries, we have a peak incidence during peak velocity, the growth spurt, and the anterior iliac spine process is the most susceptible apophysis to be injured in this core. So, to finish, I would like to thank the Aspiral Center and the physiotherapy team for all work over the last year to gather such data and such information. Thank you.